Hey guys, we are in the workshop for the first time in a little while. We're doing a real just basic thing tonight. We're gonna do a shell swap on a couple of Joy-Cons. So kick back, have a nice drink, and let's do the thing. All right. So my drink's not in the frame, is it? Okay. All right. So no soldering tonight, nothing fancy. My wife's best friend is coming in from out of state. She's flying in from New Mexico tomorrow, and she is a Switch gamer, and she loves purple, and so I got these custom purple shells by Extreme Rate, about $20 on Amazon. And so, see in there, we're going to be switching out the shells on a couple of Joy-Cons for these purples. So, this kit actually, ooh, it came with a nice looking driver. I like that. Look at that. That's fancy. All right. Does it have the bit? It has the bits and everything. Awesome. And so it comes with extra buttons too. Oh. Neat little Game Boy shaped or decorated manual there for it. That's really cool. This is not an endorsement, but well, we'll see. I mean, it's not a paid endorsement. I might endorse it anyway just because I think it's great. All right. So I've got two. So you notice here what I've got. I once upon a time needed to replace a left Joy-Con, and it was cheaper to buy a pair than to buy one individually. So I've got a brand new unused right Joy-Con here. Still in the bubble wrap in the cellophane. We're gonna do it second, and then I just bought this blue one because it was the cheapest color to buy individually on Amazon. So, so this is electric blue, the same color as the when you bought the original. If you bought an OG Switch and you either got the gray or you got the blue and the red. This is the exact color of that blue and the red. So I don't know if we can see very well if it's gonna blur or not, but you see these screws here, these screws in Joy-Cons, like most Nintendo handhelds, is a tri-wing screw. And it is a tri-wing 00 is the size we're wanting, but it looks like I said this one came with screws and drivers and everything, so that's really cool. So I'm gonna take these extra screws and put them over here. Whoa, there's a bunch of them. Wow. All right. So these will be where our aftermarket screws go, and our original Joy-Con screws we'll keep separate. And so we've got a looks like a regular Phillips bit and a tri-wing bit here. And so the regular Phillips bit is for inside it. That's this one inside the Joy-Con, and then on the outside of the Joy-Con we've got this. Man, this is really, I did not know it was going to come with this really nice looking driver. I love it. There we go. Interesting. Let's see how well it fits. Oh yeah. All right. Well, that is definitely a point in the favor of, what were they called? Extreme rate. That's definitely a point in their favor, including this nice variable driver. See, normally I have my iFixit here, which is also is great. I love my iFixit, but this is nice too. It's always nice to get a nice new driver. All right, so we're gonna move these four screws that are the shell screws. All right, cool. All right. So the thing about Joy-Cons, they have a lot of several delicate ribbon cables inside, so you want to be careful when taking them apart. But when taking it apart, the thing to think about is think of this, the charging rail, as the spine of a book, and you're just gently opening the book. So might be able to use my fingernail here, but you can also use a plastic, any kind of plastic, like a spudger or something. Like, there, I was going to say, I know I have one here on my workbench. Is a little messy. So we'll get a plastic spudger in there. There we go. All right. And I just want to gently open it. Like so. All right, like that. You see, because see those two different ribbon cables right there? So easy to tear apart. I would prefer to not even have to take those ribbon cables off. We'll see. First thing we're going to do is we're going to remove the back plate, which is attached with this screw right here. And that is a Phillips screw. Now, just for simplicity's sake, I'm going to... No, that doesn't work. There's my Phillips that I want to use. Oh, did I just put that with the... And I'm just going to use the buttons, the original Joy-Con buttons, rather than the ones that came with the kit. I don't see the point to changing those out. I'm going to set this aside for now. I'll reattach it in a minute. All right. So the battery and the shoulder button are in this they're in this little carriage assembly that looks like this. So it's like this. And you would hope that, oh, well, I could just leave the blue one, right? But it's attached. So you can actually see from this where it's attached. The shoulder button is going to be a little annoying to take off. We're going to do that. First thing we're going to do is we got another screw to undo right here. It's another Phillips screw. All right. So this is the, this white thing is the rumble motor. And it's glued in there. So it's not glued very strongly, but it is glued. Let's take out the, I'll tell you what, let's take the shoulder button out first. Or, well, no, we can take the whole thing out. It's been a long time since I did a shell swap. Mainly what I do with Joy-Cons is repair stick drift, which happens a lot, you know? All right, let's get the battery out first. How about that? So the battery is also glued in, with or taped in. I'll take the battery out. I'm going to go ahead and just unplug the battery while we're at it. No, I'm going to leave the battery in, actually. All right. Let's see, we got four more screws here, but we don't, they're not holding down this thing, I don't think. Actually, no, this one is, isn't it? Oh, there we go. I knew we had one more screw holding this thing in, and then I think that's all the screws holding this little battery holder in. Oh, there is one more. Ah, I missed it. It's like, why is this not wanting to lift? Is that it? There we go. Woohoo! And you see, right there, that's also attached. The shoulder button assembly is attached with a ribbon cable. What I would prefer is not to have to mess with taking this off. And so I'm going to, and also I don't want to mess with taking off the trigger, not shoulder button, the trigger. I'm gonna have to take the shoulder button off, but I don't have to take the trigger off. So I'm going to leave this blue attached. I'm just getting some air circulating. Sorry for the fan noise, but it's hot in my workshop. So many little screws inside this. God, that shoulder button assembly is so delicate. forgot to put the minus button on there.
Oof. putting this upside down. Oh, yes, the button's upside down, isn't it? How did the button get upside down? Forgetting the membrane. Right. Or do anything. I have a feeling that the the L button and the minus button is not going to work. Oh. I also just put the blue shell back on there. Alright. I left the blue buttons there. Oh, and also that blue right there, didn't I? Alright. That's okay. No, I mean, it's not okay. We're gonna fix it, but. What I'm doing right now, I'm just putting this back together so I can test the buttons, make sure all the buttons are correct, and then can go back and figure out. That's what I did wrong right there. I'm gonna be right back. I'm gonna go grab my switch so I can test this. Alright, so the minus button is a little sticky and should be more clicky. All right. Release button works fine. All right. So my issue is, I've got two issues to address with this one. So let's get to it. Three issues to address, actually. SL and an SR. So let's do that first. Let's fix that first. On this railing, I gotta remove these two screws. From there. Take that off. Right, that is SL. put those right back where they were. Done. Let's get the battery out of there. All right. We got three screws to take off this thing. Messing with ribbon cable crap. Everything's so delicate. There we go. Alright. And springs. Fuck a spring. Is that where the spring goes? Alright, I'm gonna go ahead and secure this battery holder back down. Hey Michelle, did you need me? Okay, I'm gonna finish this one. I'm almost done with it, and I'll do the other one tomorrow. It's taking longer than I anticipated because I'm trying to be very delicate with it. Give me like 10 more minutes, probably. Oh, I didn't fix the minus button, did I? Hate this fucking thing. Okay, I think that was it. Damn it. Son of a bitch.
All right.
All right. Now I just got to figure out how to get this shoulder button back on. I kind of want to look at the other Joy-Con real fast and see where the spring is. Maybe that'll help me, because I'm not sure where to put the spring. I've never removed the shoulder button on a Joy-Con before. Good to know. It's going to be right under this corner. It's attached to this post. It's not attached, it sits on this post. Which means if we're putting it right here. Right, that's the idea, this little thing. No, I need to see it again. Yes, so. It does go on this thing that I thought it went on. And there is, in fact, another spring. Thankfully, the kit came with extra springs. This is two springs that are stuck together. That's funny. There and there. All right. Did I just lose another one on the floor? No, it attached to my pants. That's funny. Where are my... Oh. Alright, I got it on one side. I think that's good enough. Right. All right, moment of truth. Yes, everything works. All right, one Joy-Con complete. One purple Joy-Con with all black buttons. Everything works. That's amazing. Wait, I didn't even think to trust that. Let's make sure these short, these little things work. Yes! All right. All right, that's one fully functioning purple Joy-Con. We'll do the next one tomorrow night. Thanks for tuning in, folks. Appreciate you watching, and we'll see you later.